Okay. Since this has already been out of the box several times, it's already programmed to 4024. The real train going through. Turn on the headlights. Turn off the headlight. Change direction, and the rear headlight lights up. There's the bell. Let's stir it up. Direction 8. Turn the lights on. F2 is a horn. Press it. It doesn't turn off until you press it again or hit the horn whistle button. It does it for as long as you hold it down. F3 is the coupler, couple, and then uncouple. Now we got to get this moving for the next one. F4 is dynamic brake. Feed step 7, you really hear it. This is F5's auxiliary emergency lights. This is not equipped with those. Front ditch lights flashing by default. This is F6. This does not have that. We get moving again for F7. Which is land squeal. Turn off F7. F8 is a prime mover, traction mover, short traction mover, start delay. F9 is drive hold. Every time I try to use that, it makes the locomotive not move. So I would advise not using that. F10 is the independent brake. Shift 0, F0, there's the independent brake. There's release of it. F11 is fan sound. Oops. That was F1. Don't hear anything. F12 is the dimmer. It dims the headlight. I don't know if you could see that. It's not really picking it up in the... rear ditch lights flashing by default. This does not have ditch lights, so of course that does not have that. F14, handbrake. Okay, F15 is isolation switch. Don't know if you could hear that. It's a very faint sound. F16 is air dryer on shutdown. F17 is brake set release, automatic. I'm trying to move it after playing with the sound. This is a problem. I've had this happen before when playing with the sounds, and it doesn't. Then you don't want to move it, and it doesn't want to move. That just requires simple that. Start it up. F18 is a sanding valve. Not doing anything. There it goes. And it stopped. Okay. F19 is short air light off. Supposed to be short air let off, not long. F20. Is compressor. Now this is supposed to be a, now that, if you heard it, it does have the compressor whoop. Josh Clark from NS Miler 24, someone asked him about his compressor whoop, and he said it was a custom file download, but this one came with it, so it, his might have been, this might be a later version 5 decoder. And let's see if the independent brake again. Get the air dryer, cab door. Engine compartment doors. There's the shutters open, closed. It's manual matching up to 8. Takes a while to get up there, apparently. That should be 8. No, it's still going up. Yeah, it went, finally went down to 8. So that's the sounds. Hopefully, I can edit this together and make it in one video. If not, I'll have to redo this. So that's the Atlas B40-8 or -8-40B. This unit was built April 1988 for the New York Susquehanna and Western, mainly for their Sealand trains. At that point, they were running with Norfolk Southern and D&H. Sealand container trains from the west to the east and back across the southern tier line, and these were often on those trains. They were also on other Susquehanna trains and D&H trains and Norfolk Southern trains, occasional Conrail train. They were eventually sold off in the late 90s to CSX. CSX put dish lights on them and ran them until at least 2014. This one became CSX 5945 and was in YN3 paint last time I found a photograph of it. So that concludes this video. Hopefully this is good enough and I can get this out.